Hello everyone, in this video we will study about various operations that can be performed in a drilling machine. So the first one is drilling. So drilling is the operation of producing a cylindrical hole by removing metal by the rotating edge of a cutting tool called the drill. And the standard drill bits are available in various sizes. And to drill a hole, the drill bit is rotated at very high RPM. So, drilling does not produce an accurate hole in a workpiece. And the hole so generated by this drilling becomes rough and the hole will be always slightly oversized than the drill used due to the vibration of the spindle and the drill, and it is one of the simplest method of producing a hole. So second one is boring. So boring is the operation of enlarging a hole by means of an adjustable cutting tool with only one cutting edge, and it is used where suitable size drill is not available or the hole diameter is so large that it cannot be ordinarily drilled. So to machine the internal surface of a hole already produced in casting. So this is the figure. Now the third one is countersinking. So countersinking is a metal cutting operation for making cone-shaped enlargement at the start of an already drilled hole. So and the tool used for countersinking is called countersink. And the standard countersink have 60 degree, 82 degree or 90 degree included angle. And the cutting edges of the tool are formed at the conical surface. So here is the cutting surface. And the cutting speed is 25% less than that of drilling. So the next one is reaming. So reaming is an accurate way of sizing and finishing a hole which has been previously drilled. So it is a finishing operation and does not cut significant material. So in order to finish a hole and to bring it to the accurate size, the hole is drilled slightly undersized and the speed of the spindle is made half that of the drilling. And the tool used is called the reamer. So reamer cannot originate a hole. It follows the path which has been previously drilled and removes a very small amount of metal. So this is the reamer tool and a very small amount of material is being removed by using this tool. And the next one is counter boring. So counter boring is the operation of enlarging the end of a hole cylindrically. So it is the operation of boring a second hole a larger diameter than the first but concentric with it. And the enlarged hole forms a square shoulder with the original hole. And it is necessary to accommodate the heads of bolts, studs and pins. And the tool used for counter boring is the counter bore. And the cutting speed for counter boring is 25% less than that of the drilling operations. So here you can see two holes. one with a smaller diameter and the other one with a larger diameter. So next one is tapping. So tapping is the operation of cutting internal threads by means of a cutting tool called tap. So this is the tap tool and you can see the threads on the tool. So by using this tool, internal threads are being cut on an existing hole. So this tap may be considered as a bolt with accurate threads cut on it, and this thread acts as cutting edges. So when the tap is screwed into the hole, it removes metal and cuts internal threads which will fit into the external threads of the same size. And during this operation, the spindle is rotated at very low speed. So the next operation is spot facing. So it is an operation of smoothing and squaring the surface around a hole for the seat of a nut or the head of a screw. So it is a small height counter bore, and its application is to face the area where a bolt or nut has to sit. And the tool used is a counter bore or a special spot facing tool. So the last one is trepanning. So it is the operation of producing a hole by removing metal along the circumference of a hollow cutting tool. So a cutter consists of one or more cutting edges placed along the circumference of a circle is used to produce the annular groove. So it is feasible if the hole has a diameter of more than 50 mm. So trepanning operation is performed for producing large holes, and fewer chips are removed and much of the material is saved while the hole is being produced, and the tool is operated at higher speed, and this is one of the efficient method of producing a hole. So these are the various operations that can be performed in a drilling machine. Thank you.